In this video, we'll showcase a Forge app developed by our team of Atlassian platform engineers. This app enhances Bitbucket by providing essential information directly where it's needed. Stay tuned till the end to learn how you can integrate this app into your team's workspace and enhance their pull request experience. Many teams create their own set of best practices for pull requests. And this is done to improve teamwork and to reduce the time taken for pull request reviews. However, these best practices are often stored as separate pages, making them difficult for every team member to find. Additionally, these pages may contain a lot of information that is not directly relevant to the specific pull request being reviewed by a developer. What if I told you that you can easily bring the most important PR best practices to your team and the currently open PR directly in the Bitbucket UI using Forge? The app presents the two most common best practices available here. When creating a pull request, it's important to provide a detailed description using rich text content. This helps reviewer understand the context of the changes and makes the review process smoother. Remember, a well-crafted description can make a big difference in how your pull request is reviewed. With the app, if the author forgets to include the relevant elements in a pull request, a warning icon is displayed, like here. When you click the Learn More button, a dialog appears, this one. The numbers you see indicate the current count of headings, images, and links in the description. In our case, we only have one heading, while number of images and number of links is equal to zero. Our Forge app can access the pull request context and all Bitbucket REST APIs and read and display the number of each element live. The second best practice, which is available here as comment prefixes, is something most people find even more interesting. Let's check what happens when we click on the Learn More button. Have you ever felt unsure about whether a comment on your pull request is just a suggestion or something that must be addressed? Reviewing a pull request involves asynchronous feedback, which can be quite complex to navigate. To make the intent of comments clear to both reviewers and authors, why not use a standard set of prefixes? For instance, you could use required to indicate that a change must be addressed, or QQ when asking a clarifying question. This practice can make the review process more transparent and efficient for everyone involved. In this Forge app, we implemented two common best practices for managing pull requests. These practices are widely used across our Atlassian teams and can greatly improve the PR process. You can either use these practices as they are or consider adding to the app additional best practices to further enhance your PR workflow. Other common best practices you might want to consider include ensuring that the PR isn't excessively large, restricting the number of comments, timely closure of the PR. If you are keen on exploring the repository, you can find the link in the video description below. In the context of a pull request, it's incredibly beneficial to see the best practices in action. Our app takes this a step further by offering an additional feature that allows us to mark a PR as exemplary, and it's available here. Mark as exemplary. The PRs that have been marked as exemplary are then showcased in an additional component added by the app. This component is available on the main page of a repository, and we can find it here. This is perfect for developers who are eager to learn from others and understand what makes a good PR. And if you click on the Learn More, you'll see a dialogue popping up explaining why a PR has been marked as exemplary. The PR Best Practices app is created using Forge, which is Atlassian Cloud Developer Platform. Forge is designed to customize and extend Atlassian Cloud products. It is included in every cloud plan for free, and it allows every developer to start building an app today. In this video, we learned about adding UI components to the PR page and the repository page, interacting with the content of the PR using the Bitbucket REST APIs, using the forge storage capability to save the reference to the exemplary PR and to retrieve it. To learn more about Forge, this app, and how to start using it, you can find the links in the video description below. If you have any questions, you can visit our community. The link is also available in the description of this video. And if you found this video helpful, let us know and check out the other videos in this playlist. Bye!